After the death of Walter Reuther in 1970, Leonard Woodcock became president of the UAW. Later that year, he led a hard-fought 67-day strike against General Motors, the first major challenge by the UAW to GM. The strikes challenged GM's strategy of opening new non-union supply plants in the South. Woodcock retired in 1976 and became the United States Chief of Mission in China, and was appointed by President Carter to head a commission in Vietnam and Laos to find Americans missing in action in the Vietnam War.
Rapid action is needed to resolve the questions regarding future standards, or auto production will be severely disrupted with widespread economic impact.
We talk about delays, and we talk about the fact that the numbers in this statute are sacrosanct. The numbers in the statute of the Air Amendment Acts of 1970 were, somebody said, let's reduce all the pollutants by 90%. And that reduction by 90% brings us to X, Y, and Z, therefore X, Y, and Z are the numbers. And they've suddenly become sacrosanct. They weren't based upon any scientific analysis. They weren't based upon any technological analysis. They were based upon a very good, in my opinion, assumption that their feet needed to be kept to the fire, because they began by saying, the automobile isn't even a part of the problem, and we don't need to do anything.
Would the auto industry be able to manufacture a normal auto year in the year coming up?
They stated when we were on the Senate side that the numbers are not changed, we will not violate the law, we will simply shut down. And that process begins by the month of July. I say that simply as a statement of fact.
I want to commend you, Mr. Woodcock, for your position, and I know that in your recommendation that the health considerations were a very prime factor in the judgment that you have made.